Welcome friends to the UGC NET Coaching contact class of Sri Neelakanda Government Sanskrit College Pattambi Learning Management System. I am Prasanna PK, Associate Professor of Economics, SNGS College Pattambi. For the second paper, we have a topic on public finance. On that, we have different portions like public expenditure, public revenue, public debt, budget, central state financial relations, local finance, etc. to deal with. Current presentation is on public finance, public revenue and its sources. Before coming to public revenue and its sources, we have to mention something about what is public finance and its importance and the role of government in the society. What is public finance? Public finance is the study of financial aspects of the government. In public finance, government deals income and expenditure to attain various economic and social goals. The term public finance has been variously defined by different economies. The most acceptable definition is given by Professor Bastable. According to Professor Bastable, a well-known writer of the 19th century, public finance deals with expenditure and income of the public authorities of the state and their mutual relation, and also with the financial administration and control. So, we can understand that in public finance, government deals its income and expenditure to attain maximum public welfare. The subject matter of public finance consists of all aspects concerning the income and expenditure activities of the government. The subject matter of public finance broadly consists of public revenue, public expenditure, public debt, financial administration, and economic stabilization. The role of the government in public finance is increasing day by day. The role of the government during past has had only police functions. In the 19th century, the classical economists believed in laissez-faire policy or let alone policy. What is laissez-faire policy? Laissez-faire policy means non-governmental interference in the economic activities of the people. Let the people free to do any economic activities as they wish. Government need not interfere in the economic activities of the people. During past, government had only police functions to do. They were to maintain law and order within the country, or to protect the country from external aggression, or to maintain public institutions. These were the main functions of the government during the 19th century. But the picture has changed nowadays. Modern governments are welfare governments. The aim of the modern government is to attain maximum public welfare. In order to attain maximum public welfare, government has to undertake various programs and projects, and government has to raise revenue to finance all these developmental projects. Then only government can function very well and attain its social and economic objectives. So from this we can understand that the role of the government is increasing day by day, and the role of public expenditure and public revenue is also very important nowadays. And let us come to the point, what is public revenue? Public revenue is the income of the government from various sources. That is, income of the government through all sources is called public revenue. According to Professor Dalton, public revenue include all the income and receipts which the government may secure during any given period of time. Government has various sources of public revenue, and they are broadly divided into two heads, and they are major public revenue sources are tax revenue and non-tax revenue. Tax revenue means revenue received by the government from the collection of taxes. And tax constitute the major and important source of revenue to the government. What is tax? What do you mean by tax? There are various definitions to tax, and the most acceptable one is given by Professor Seligman. According to Professor Seligman, a tax is a compulsory contribution from the person to the government to defray the expenses incurred in the common interest of all without reference to special benefits conferred. It's a clear definition, and we can get clear points or clear features of tax from this definition. So what are the important features of tax? A tax is a compulsory contribution, and it is from the people to the government, and the tax is levied by the government on person. There is a personal obligation from the part of the person on whom a tax is levied. The non-payment of tax is illegal, considered as illegal, and it is punishable. And there is no direct quid pro quo element in tax. That is, there is no give and take policy in the case of tax. Taxpayer, that means the taxpayer does not get direct benefit from the government. So we can say that there is no direct quid pro quo, there is no personal benefit to the taxpayer in paying the tax. And this tax revenue is used by the government for common benefit. Tax revenue is used by the government for getting common welfare and not for personal welfare. So these are the important features of tax. There are different kinds of taxes based on assessment. Taxes are classified into direct tax and indirect tax. Direct example for direct tax is personal income tax, corporate tax, land tax, profession tax, etc. Example for indirect taxes are GST, VAT, sales tax, custom duty, etc. And based on the rate of tax, taxes are classified into progressive, proportional, regressive and degressive. And progressive tax is considered as most equitable tax, which promote equity in the economy or equality in the economy. Based on the weight of the commodity, taxes may be specific tax, and based on the value of the commodity, taxes are ad valorem, considered as ad valorem taxes. And we will come, there are various theories to taxes and tax burden, incidence of tax, etc. We will come into those parts in later classes. Let us come to non-tax revenue source. Non-tax revenue source means revenue or income received by the government from sources other than taxes. Major non-tax revenue source of the government are commercial revenue, administrative revenue, grants and gifts, and public borrowing. What is commercial revenue? Commercial revenue is the revenue received in the form of price paid for commodities and services produced by public enterprises. They include payment of postage, tolls, electricity and water charges, income from railways, etc. Then, what is administrative revenue? Administrative revenue is the receipts or income accrued on account of performing administrative functions of the government. There are various items included in administrative revenue. They are fees, fines and penalties, forfeiture, escheat, special assessment, etc. Fees. According to Professor Seligman, fees is payment to defray the cost of each recurring service undertaken by the government in public interest. Example, court fee, license fee, passport fee, etc. Fines and penalties. Fines and penalties are levied and collected from offenders of law as punishment. Forfeitures. Forfeitures is a penalty imposed by the court for the failure of individuals to appear in the court to complete certain contract as stipulated. Then what is escheat? Escheat refers to the claim of a government over the property of a person who died without any legal heirs or without keeping a will. Then special assessment is a type of administrative revenue, and Professor Seligman defines special assessment as a compulsory payment made by the people towards meeting the cost of a specific improvement to property undertaken in the public interest. That is, when government undertakes a public utility work like construction of road, bridge or drainage or street lighting, etc., it will create a common benefit to all. At the same time, special benefit to those properties nearby. So the property owners should pay some levy to the government in proportionate to the increase in the value of their property. It is called a special assessment. And another, these are the important administrative revenues received by the government. And government has another non-tax revenue source, that is grants and gifts. Here, gifts are voluntary contributions from individuals or non-government donors to the government fund established for some special purpose. For example, relief fund, defense fund, during a fund created for a war or an emergency or flood, drought, etc. Grants are receipts of our country from another country. Many advanced or developed countries of the world, such as USA, Germany, etc., give grants to the developing countries such as India, Pakistan, etc., for their economic development. Moreover, various international organizations like World Bank, IMF, etc., give grants to poor and developing countries. Or grants will be given by the center to the state. So it constitutes an important non-tax revenue source of the government. Next non-tax revenue source is public borrowing. Public borrowing is a non-tax revenue source to the government. In the modern world, every government uses the method of raising public loans. Government has various sources of public borrowing. Government can raise loans from within the citizens of the country or from within the or from financial institutions within the country, or government can borrow from outside the country, that is from citizens of the foreign country or from foreign financial institutions or from international financial institutions like IMF, IBRD, etc. It is considered as the most developing countries considered public borrowing as a source of revenue. But public borrowing imposes certain burden to the economy. If it increases, it increases the burden of the economy. It creates or it imposes internal burden as well as external burden. So that's all for today.